to the 16th session of the Srimad Bhagavat Katha. This morning, Paniji talked about the Govardhan Puja and how it became, and how Sri Krishna advised the people to not only pray to the mountain, but also to the Brahmins, the sun, the earth, the cows, the water, and all of natural entities and everything that has a godly spirit or gives something to humanity. And that was a very short summary. So I'd like to hand over the microphone to Pandit Rupnath Sharma, who will be officiating today.
Giridhar Bana He Nandana Giridhar Bana Giridhar Bana He Nandana Giridhar Bana He Nandana
सभी लोग खड़े हो जाए, आरती करेंगे। बिन्यू आरती शिवा के बिहारी।
श्री बांके बिहारी आरती गाओ,
श्री बांके बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्री बांके बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्री बांके बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्याम
सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्याम सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ,
कृपा के बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
कृपा के बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्री कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्याम सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्याम सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ।
प्यारे मंदिर मन मोहे, देख छवि बलिहारी गाओ,
हार तेरी आरती गाओ, शिवा के बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ, कुंज बिहारी
के बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्याम सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ,
श्याम सुंदर तेरी आरती
चरण से निकली गंगा प्यारी,
चरण से निकली गंगा प्यारी,
जिसे सारी दिया तारी,
जिसे सारी दुनिया तारी,
जिसने सारी दुनिया तारी,
जिसने सारी दर्शन पाऊं, मैं उन चरणों में दर्शन पाऊं,
बांके बिहारी तेरी आरती गाऊं,
बांके बिहारी तेरी आरती गाऊं,
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाऊं,
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाऊं,
तेरी आरती गाओ,
सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ।
दास नाथ की नाथ आप हो,
दास नाथ की नाथ
प्यारे तत्व दुख सुख जीवन प्यारे सारे हरि चरणों में शीश नवाओ हरि चरणों में शीश नवाओ बात बिहारी के आरती गाओ पाने आरती गाओ कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
काम सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ प्यार तुम हो
श्री हरिदास के प्यार तुम हो
मेरे मोहन जीवन धन हो
मेरे मोहन जीवन धन हो
देखी गलत बलि बलि गाओ
देखो गलत बलि बलि गाओ
बात बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
राम सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ पाके बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
पाके बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
कुंज बिहारी तेरी आरती गाओ
श्याम सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ
श्याम सुंदर तेरी आरती गाओ
पाके बिहारी तेरी
विश्व कन्हैया लाल, लाल की माँ के बिहारी लाल की श्याम सुंदर वाले की सभी लोग आशी जी
लेट अस ओपन ईच क्लास्प योर हैंड्स एंड क्लोज योर आईज एज वी ऑफर इनवोकिंग इनवोकेशन टू द डिवाइन To bring our minds at a state of reception to the glories of the Divine Lord.
Om, Om Sri Ganesha. Om Sri
Saraswati.
Om. श्री गुरु चरण कमले ध्येयं सदा परिभवज्ञम विष्टदोहम् तीर्थास्पदं श्रीविवञ्चिनु तं शरण्यम् मृत्यार्तिहं प्रणतपालभवाद् विभूतम् वन्दे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् वन्दे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् वंशी विभूषित करान नवनीरधाबा पीतांबर दरुंद बिंब पलात दरुष्टा पूर्णेन्द्र सुंदर मुकार विंदनेत्र कृष्णा परम किमपि तत्वमहं न जाने तत्वमहं न जाने नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जय मुदीरये ततो जय मुदीरये सच्चिदानन्दरूपाय विश्वपद्यादिहेत तापत्रय विनाशाय श्री कृष्णाय स्वयं श्री कृष्णाय स्वयं
जय जय श्री राधा रमण जय जय नवल किशोर जय गोपी चित चोर प्रभु
जय जय माखन जय जय This morning, we discussed that how it's important for us to understand that our karma is what makes us or breaks us. We are what we think, we are what we do, and we are what we speak. Mansa karma vaja. Today I want to discuss what are the influential factors that influences our karma. When we rise in the morning, the sun has a great influence on how we feel. For instance, when we open our eyes and we see the sunshine, nice day. But although the sun could be shining, I could open my eyes and say, another day. So although the sunshine is supposed to have a positive effect, because of my state of mind, I am having a negative response. What are the controlling factors that controls that state of mind that leads up to the karma of not appreciating the sunshine? By the way, that's karma, not appreciating the sunshine or appreciating the sunshine. So I want us to understand clearly the karma, the thought, the acceptance, the acknowledgement, the disagreement. These are all karma. What influences? The sun is bright, but yet I choose not to be happy. The sun is bright, I choose to be happy. There is no sunshine, I choose to be happy. There is no sunshine, I choose to be unhappy. The sun is only being the sun. It shines, and by the way, the sun is always shining. The sun never stops shining. You and I, because we're sitting on the earth and it's moving around, we say the sun went down, but the sun is still there. He's glowing 24 hours, brilliant as ever. But as we go around, we have a different perspective. Oh, the sun is going down and it's getting darker and darker. But who's going out? it's you and I who are going away, and we are experiencing darkness because we have moved away from the light.
Sri Krishna Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo.
In the departing years, as the Divine Lord prepares to depart from this mortal world, He sits with Uddho, His faithful servant. And again, He begins to lecture to Uddho. And His discourse today is on what are the influential factors that we allow to influence our karma. We are told, Sri Bhagavan Vacha.
सत्वं राजसं इति गुणा बुद्धेर्न सात्मनः सत्वेनान्यत्मा हन्यात् सत्वं सत्वेव चैव हि सत्वं सत्वेव चैव हि सत्वा धर्मो भवेद् बृदां पुंसो भक्ति लक्षण सत्विकोपासय सत्वम ततो धर्म प्रवर्तिते ततो धर्म प्रवर्तिते श्री कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय गोविंदाय नमो नमो श्री कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय गोविंदाय नमो नमो
सत्व राजस और तामस थ्री स्टेट्स ऑफ माइंड मॉडर्न डे साइकोलॉजी कॉल्स इट द इड द ईगो एंड द सुपर ईगो Sattva, Raja, and Tamas. Now, we all, by the way, have the basic essence to experience or to be influenced by Sattva, Rajas, or Tamas. But the influence, it doesn't influence our body, by the way. It says, this Sattva, Raja, Tamas, these modes are of the buddhi. Buddhi meaning our sense of thought and thinking. That we care, our feelings anyway, our feelings. You know, we have good feelings, we have bad feelings, we have no feelings, average feelings, hateful feelings, lustful feelings, greedful feelings, feelings. But all of them are influenced by tamas, raja, and sattva. And these feelings, it's not a gift from God, by the way. This is our own. It comes from what is called prakriti. Lack of a better word, nature. It's your nature to be like that. You're always hungry in the morning. You can't be happy until you've had your first coffee. Your prakriti. But that prakriti is what we make it. We may choose to smile every morning, regardless of who we see. But we have to make a conscious thought to do that. Now, this Sattva, Raja and Tamas, he says Sattva, the Sattvic state, shapes the other two states. The Sattvic state shapes the other two states. And the other two states eradicate the sattvic state. That is, if you are in a sattvic state, you are able to control Raja and Tamas. If you are in Tamasic and Rajasic state, you eliminate sattvic state. Song is confusing. All right, let's go back to our milk and ghee scenario. I have a bottle of milk, or a pot of milk to be exact. Milk has water, it has milk, and there is ghee. Can you see it when you hold the bottle of milk? Can you see the water? What do you see? Consider the milk the rajas. Consider the ghee to be the sattvic. And consider the water, which is underlining, as the tamas. How do you separate the water from the milk? And in the same process, get the ghee. When you have the ghee, you don't need the water and the milk anymore. You've taken everything out of them. But if you have only water, you can put more water in that milk, you'll thin it out, but ghee will never ever come to play. Confused? Yeah, okay? Let's break it down again. The milk has known fact, water, and there's milk. And then you have the potential to get ghee. But how do you get this? You have to boil the milk to a point in time, and eventually you will see the water that will be extracted, and then the cream of that milk, the milk becomes cream, and the cream when churned becomes ghee. But when you have the milk alone, you never see the ghee. When you have the water alone, you never see the ghee. When the water and the milk together, you never see the ghee. But when you get the ghee, you don't want the water and the milk anymore, because you have the essence of it all. Still confused? Now, how do we relate that to our lives? How do we separate the water and the milk, which is the raja, the tamas and rajasic, and only enjoy the creme de la creme, the ghee of life? And what's the ghee of life? By the way, all of these are not physical things. I gave you a relationship of something physical. But we have to do this separation in our minds. We have to say, hold on a minute, that's tamas. Hold on a minute, that's rajasic. And if we are focusing on burning out the tamas and the rajasic, we don't have to call in sattva. You don't have to say, ghee, arrive. You just burn the milk up, burn the water up, churn the butter, ghee. Ghee is the end result of the destruction of rajas and tamas. Let's talk about our state of mind, and let's go back to the sun in the morning and our state of minds. And all of us know who we are like in the morning. Now, if we are pleasant, then we'll be pleasant. If we are unpleasant, what do we attribute our unpleasantness to? Don't put your hands up now. I didn't sleep good. Don't bother me. I have a bad day. You know how much weight last night. We find everything possible to attribute our ugly state of mind. And by the way, none of those things are responsible for ugly state of mind. Who's responsible for ugly state of mind? Who? We are. We diligently make that choice to be mean or nasty or just unfriendly. But we can deliberately, remember last night, no action is without deliberation. Or you're either deliberately doing it or you're doing it without even thinking. But the deliberate action bears fruit. The undeliberate action potentially have fruit. Now when I said deliberate action bears fruit, if you're deliberately being mean, it will bear fruit. Mean fruit. If you're deliberately being nice, it will give you good fruits. But deliberate action brings fruit. It is my intention to be mean. Right? I will get the fruit of meanness. It is my intention to be sweet. I will get the fruit of sweetness. Now in our tradition, we were told that when you rise in the morning, that the first thing you must do, whom serve you see? Jai Sita. We must bring God to the forefront, right away, and bring Him to be the union that brings us together with humanity by respecting God. We're told to say pranam. We're told that as children we must bow to our parents' feet and all of that. But the realities are that it's very impractical. Sometimes parents don't get up, children don't get up on time. But whenever the eyes do meet, let the eyes meet with joy. Let it be blessedness. So here, our katha today, how do we identify how these three states influences our karma? And remember, smile is a karma. Anger is a karma. Smirkiness is a karma. Twisting the eyes is a karma. Relaxing the face is the karma. All of these are karma. Giving the nose up is a karma. Giving the thumbs up is a karma. Giving the thumbs down is a karma. All these, but every one of them, you know, is influenced by Rajas, Tamas, etc. Now these three people, they're not bad, you know. Water is not bad. Milk is not bad. But it's water and milk that makes ghee. It's not bad. But you got to get rid of water and milk to get ghee. So they sacrifice themselves so that ghee can be a reality. We have to find a way to sacrifice our rajas, our tamas, and rajasic, our id and ego, so that we can get the ghee of life with the sattvic state. We have to suppress our animalistic qualities. We have to overcome our egotistical tendencies. And by doing that, the end result is ghee. Maybe we should say ice cream. It would be more relevant. Yes. But the essence of it comes after that. Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo Namo. Bolo.
Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo Namo.
He goes on to explain. Dharmo rajastamo hanyat sattvibhridhyanutama ashu nashyati panmulo. Hey dharma ubhayate, hey dharma ubhayate. Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Govindaya Namo Namo.
Sri Krishnaya
Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo Namo.
He says, if one is engaged in a state of sattva state, in by being in that state, it suppresses the rajasic state. For instance, we're all here and we've been here for 5-6 days, coming every day. I am positive that every one of us have realized that, you know, the desires and the tendencies that I have on the other days, I don't have them now in these days when I'm involved in this type of devotion. Or I am contemplating them, but they do not disturb my life. I let them be passing thoughts. True? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes? That's a firm answer. What about the rest of you? Yes or no? Sita and Rukmini, one is the Dharmapatni of Prabhu Sri Ram, and the other one is the Dharmapatni of Krishna. So they don't have any problems. Right? But Tara and Sunita, they have problems. They live in reality. Okay. So since Rukmini and Sita doesn't have these thoughts because they are the Divine Mother, the ordinary people like you and I, we have these problems. But the fact is that when we are in an environment, the environment pervades our state. But when that environment is the internal environment, which state of mind is what we're talking about, when we are in a sattvic state, I can tell you for me for sure, I know it has had tremendous impact. I am prone to getting angry. Believe you me, I have been tempted so many times over the last, and I have realized that I can restrain my anger even easier. Okay? And events are coming up that I'm saying, let it be, let it be, let it be. As such, once the poet, Bhagavan Krishna is telling Uddhava that, oh Uddhava, when you are working in the sattvic state, you are definitely in a better position to manage the rajasic and tamasic state. He said, but if you exist in a tamasic state and the rajasic state, getting to sattvic is very, very tall ladder to climb. Now, someone said, Pandiji, so how do I jump from this boat to that boat? How do I jump from this boat to that boat? I must realize which boat I'm in. I must realize you have a weight problem. Not that anybody here has a weight problem. You know you have a weight problem. You want to get out of the weight problem. What do? You buy a box of candies. You go to someone who can advise you. Let's say you go to the doctor or the dietitian who says, by the way, do we agree that you have a weight problem? And when you get there, you say, no, I don't have a weight problem. Okay, you're in the wrong place. Go home. Come back next week when you know what you have. Oh, I think I have a weight problem. That's not a bad weight problem. There are other people more heavier than I am. Go home. Think about it again. Come back. Do you think you have a weight problem? Yeah, I do. Okay, we can talk then. But until we are convinced that we are operating in the tamasic and the rajasic state, no doctor, no advisor, no guru, not even God can help us. Once we admit that we are in that state, that we are overweight, then, all right, I'm overweight. Do you like being overweight? No. Then, do you want to do something about it? Yes. Good. Now we're walking up, we're a third step up. So, the doctor says, the dietitian, I have a method for you. Method is, let's talk about what you eat, when do you eat it, when do you sleep. You mean all of that I have to go through? Fine, I'll just live with the weight. Okay, go home. That's exactly what happens in life. When we have these tendencies, and sometimes we know we have them. Sometimes the best friend sits with us and tells us we have them. We agree with the best friend that we have them. And then when we find out that what we have to do to change them, it's okay, leave me alone. I'm happy with the way I am. Yes? No? Maybe. Yes. And then when we get really overweight again, and then the overweight is not only overweight, it's causing heart problems. And the doctor says, by the way, if you don't lose this weight, the ticker is going to stop. We go back to the doctor again. Oh, I think I've got to lose this weight now. Why? Now I got a heart problem. Well, I got to do all that. Yes. But you see, it is better to nip it in the bud, as they say. If we are wise enough to nip these tamasic and rajasic qualities in the bud, then the overweight burden on the mind of the state of who we are is easily overcome. But if we do not accept it, and by the way, every person who have these tendencies knows that they have them. Some choose not to accept it. They were told 100 times. And by the way, they're very sorry for these things, the state of mind. I am very sorry when I get angry. Nobody is sorry like I am when I get angry. I don't think anyone can even punish me as much as I punish myself when I get angry. Especially when I get angry and I hurt someone else. No one can punish me like I punish myself. So we have self. I'm speaking about myself. Every one of us can relate to our own selves. So Bhagavan Krishna is telling, but this is the word of God to man. Uddhava represents you and I. And Bhagavan Krishna is telling him personally. And he goes on to talk to him.
Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya
Namo Namah.
One more time, please.
Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo Namah.
आगमुप प्रजादेश कालकर्म च जन्म च ज्ञानं मंत्रोत संस्कारो दशोते गुणहे तव दशोते गुणहे तव
स्क्रिप्चर्स होली बुक्स वॉटर द पीपल द एनवायरमेंट द प्लेस द वी लिव इन द सराउंडिंग्स टाइम our occupation, birth, what we spend all of our time thinking about, what we contemplate on, the mantras that we chant, pujas that we do, all of these 10 aspects of our lives contribute to the growth of a particular guna. Guna meaning tamas, rajas, or sattvic. All of them contribute to the growth of one of these things. Now, you mean when I'm doing puja, this could contribute to the growth of my tamasic qualities? When I'm doing puja, this could contribute to the growth of my rajasic qualities? It's supposed to only contribute to my sattvic qualities. But Bhagavan Krishna is telling Uddhava, but you know what? All of those things, water we bathe in, the food we eat, the environment we sleep in, the thoughts that we perceive, the people we associate with, all of them will contribute to the growth or the demise of one of these gunas. Now let's talk about puja or charity. How can charity contribute to tamas and rajas gunas? Isn't charity a good thing? Of course it's a good thing. But charity given with expectation, charity given out to show, charity given to make your name, charity given for fame, is influenced by which guna? Rajas, or even a little bit of tamas. But if that is given, whereby it is given out the desire to give, the great value of no expectation, and to someone who does not even know that it's been given to them by you, he says, that is influenced by the sattvic. The same $100 that you gave could bring different values back. If it's given in a certain state, the tamasic state, the value is devalued. A rajasic state is devalued. A sattvic state, it gets interest. Now, you might have heard my little story about Shah Rukh Khan one day. You know, very, very famous actor in Mumbai. One morning he was there and he got out very early. And his latest movie was released and big millions of dollars they're making. And he felt so good and he said, I'm going to do some good today. So he goes outside and as Sumi told me, I've never stayed in Mumbai, but she did a lot. She says, that place never sleeps. 24 hours a day they are moving and talking and walking. And so he goes out to the street corner, but it was very early, maybe 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning. And there is this man who is on his knees, who's got this little scooter thing going around. A crippled person running around. He said, hey, come here. And the man looked at him and said, oh my God, it's you. How are you? The number one movie star of India. Oh, yeah, no, please. Here, take this. He whips out an American $100 bill and gives it to the man. The man goes berserk. Wow! And he's rearing and screaming, running around to all his friends. Look what he gave me. Look, $100 American. He's such a great man, the greatest Indian that we have in this country. Everybody say, Kaun hai, who? Oh, the number one movie star. You don't know him? Who it is? Well, by this time, while this is all happening, Shah Rukh Khan went and hid in the corner and just enjoying this glorification. And then this beggar friend says, hey, who was it? What do you mean you don't know who it was? Of course, the only number one Indian star. Who that? Hrithik Roshan, of course. Shah Rukh Khan. You see, we give because we are waiting for our name to be mentioned. when it didn't get mentioned, no, they didn't mention my name. So, and I give so much. What kind of gift was that? Rajasic. But yet, it's the same $100. If he had given it to the man and says, go make your life happy, don't tell anyone you meet me, don't want anybody to know. By the way, do you know my name? No, I'm John Henry. That's it. Good. My name is not important. How you value and get from this, I pray will bring value to you. So, Bhagavan Krishna is telling Arjuna, not Arjuna, Uddhava, that Uddhava, these tendencies, this is part of my maya. I created this Rajas, Tamas and Sattvic. Somebody said, why did God do that? Why didn't you just get rid of these tendencies and make everybody have Sattvic tendencies? An easy answer? Then we would have a world of dummies. Robots programmed, only to do one. But the value of coming in human existence is that we have ability and power of choice. And that is why we live in a world where the human rights code is so much respected, that the right to be must never be taken away from anyone. And when we have the right to be, we must exercise the right in a righteous way. When we have the right to be, we must exercise it in a righteous way.
Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo.
He goes on.
Tatat sachitvakame vaisham yad yad vridha prayakshate nindanti tamasam tad rajasam tadupeshitam rajasam tadupeshitam Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo.
He says of all of these 10 things that I described to you, every one of us as human beings have the ability to make some statement about them. Now water is water is water. It's always good. But if you jump into the water and you put your head underneath, you will drown. So, if the man who has water puts his head under the water and feels he's suffocating and then gets up and says, this damn water, it nearly killed me. This damn water nearly killed me. If the man who eats his food, and food is good, and who overeats and gets an upset stomach, this damn food caused an upset stomach. Or is it the damn fool who caused the upset stomach? Bhagavan Krishna is saying that you and I, we will be influenced by a Rajasic or Tamasic and Sattvic, and we will, as we address and appreciate these things in the world, we will find the water to be very Sattvic, because water is good for me, Brinkley. We could say the water is Rajasic, or we can make ourselves make a tamasic, a rajasic statement. Water, oh, this dirty water, oh, this water that nearly killed me, oh, this water. The water says, I'm only water. You made it, you made me dirty, you made me hot, you made me cold, you made me what? I am only water, and I will always be water. This fire, oh, this fire burned my hand. What kind of fire is this? The fire says, hey, that's what I'm all about, burning. Anything you put, I will burn. You put Bhagavan's murti there, I will burn that too. I am not Rajasic, neither am I Tamasic, neither am I Sattvic. The fire, nor the water, nor the tree, nor the air are not influenced by these gunas. Who are influenced by them? Hamsa. We are. That is the challenging factor of human existence. He says, you got human quality, now you have a challenge. You have some more influential factors. You don't have human qualities, you don't have these influential factors. As such, the tree will always be the tree. And we describe Bhagavan Krishna telling Balaram that when he was walking through the forest, that he said, look at these trees. Huh? How sattvic they are. They grow with such grace. They provide limbs for shade who walks under them. They provide a cool place to rest. They allow mankind to take their leaves and use it for food. They allow mankind to cut the branches to make homes and to make things in the need. They allow mankind to burn the bark and to bring heat. They allow mankind to use it. And he said they give everything, entire their life. And they never ever complain. He says, yes, sattvic. But by the way, they're not influenced by tamas and rajas. They're all sattvic. And we are influenced by them.
Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo.
Therefore,
sattvika kamyeva sevat umana sattvida bhridyate tato dharmastato jnanam yavat smiti parapohanam yavat smiti parapohanam Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya
For the predominance of sattvic qualities, man should make use of only sattvic things. If you want to smell sweet, don't get bad smelling perfume. Get sweet smelling perfume. But you know, you could get some things that smell very bad. He says, if you want sattvic to predominance, then only engage and utilize that which is sattvic. Now, here goes. During this yajna, we are told that we should not eat food with onion and garlic and so on. Why is that? Yes. Why? Speak to the microphone.
It influences the senses.
It stimulates?
Stimulates
the senses. And when the senses stimulate, which of the gunas becomes activated? The tamasic, the base, the animalistic qualities. So we are told not to eat things that will stimulate the tamasic qualities because we want to be in a sattvic state. Here Bhagavan Krishna is telling Uddhava that, oh Uddhava, do not, in order for the sattvic state to be dominant, then be engaged only in sattvic articles and in sattvic environment. He says, what you eat, where you are, how you think, will influence who you are. True?
Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo Namo.
He says, if we consistently maintain the right environment, utilize only the sattvic articles in our lives, have only sattvic thoughts, engage in sattvic activity, he says, then we will get self-realization. Self-realization doesn't mean we die. Self-realization means we can see God crystal clear. Here, there and everywhere. But firstly, Hridayame, we see him there first. And he says, when we can see him there, we can place the picture everywhere. But if we cannot see Bhagavan within our minds, we will have a big problem seeing him anywhere.
Sri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya
The Lord makes his final analogy on this subject.
Venu sanga sarjo bihadya durdhava shayati tadunam एवं गुणत्यत्य जो देहा शांति तत्री क्रिया शांति तत्र क्रिया श्री कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय गोविंदाय नमो नमः.
To have fire, something has to be burnt. To have fire, something has to be burnt. You take a few sticks and you put them together and you ignite a fire, the fire will burn as long as it sticks. Once the sticks are consumed to ashes, what happens to the fire? It's gone. So, is the fire the sticks? Where did the fire go? So the fire is not getting the fuel, so the fire will disappear. If we do not fuel the fire of sattvic with the fuel of good deeds, the fire, sometimes we have some good thoughts and we fuel the fire of goodness and sattvic rise to the higher level, and then as soon as the day goes by, it's gone, we're back to the rajasic. And we're burning rajasic fuel and the rajasic fire takes over. So we have to nurture the fire of sattvic with the fuel of sattvic actions, sattvic thoughts, sattvic karma. But if we have in the right environment we are in, whereby we are in the sattvic environment, but we are fueling our day-to-day thoughts with the rajasic and tamasic, then we will have the fire of rajas and tamas dominant and the fire of sattvic will be extinguished. Now this sounds a little bit complicated at times, but we have to think of it simple. And I like the analogy, the best one I can have is the analogy of making butter a ghee or extracting juice from a fruit. Juice from a fruit. You have a fruit. Now you bite on it and the juice dribbles all over your face. But what you wanted was only the juice. So what's going to happen to that fruit? Something's going to have to be thrown away, isn't it? If you have one of those big juicers, right? Do you know how much you throw away? If you weigh what you throw away versus what you get to drink, what you throw away is a lot. And many of us says like, look at how much I'm throwing away. But you wanted the juice. The juice have all the vitamins. That's the husk. So you take the skin of the fruit, you peel it, you throw it away. That's tamas, gone, down the road. Then you take the fruit, you throw it in that blender and you grind it up. And you're getting all the juice. That's the sattvic. And then you look at the rajasic and says, oh my God, I gotta throw away all. That's painful. Look at how much of this. Oh my, all of this. And that's painful, but when you do that and you hold the glass of juice in your hands and you savor it, wow. Ehi tamas, rajas, or sattvic. But we have to give up something to get this ecstasy of sattvic state. Prem Swati Krishna Chanda Bhagavan Ki Jai. Let me take this opportunity to thank all of you for being here today. This, we are coming down now to tomorrow, isn't it? 3 days? We have 5 more, yes. We have 3 tomorrow, 1 more tonight, and 1 on Sunday morning. 5 more sessions of Bhagavad Katha. Tonight we shall be dealing with the wonderful character of Sudama. And of course, the most auspicious Lord, Krishna. So, join us tonight from 7 p.m. and we will be presenting the katha of the meeting again of Krishna and Sudama after being separated for quite some time. I presented everyone with this thought in their minds that to fuel your minds with this thought, with a sattvic type of state, Since Krishna and Sudama were boyhood friends, they spent time together. They ate from the same plate, to be exact. And Krishna is the divine Lord, and he can give anything to anyone or make anything for anyone possible. Why is it that Sudama was impoverished, didn't have any materialistic wealth, and Krishna was still his best friend? Tonight you will give me the answer. Beda thought in our minds. As we conclude today, Aarti banakar, aap akele hain? Gobind kahan? Bahar, bola hai. In summary of our katha today, we talked about the tendencies that you and I have, that as human beings we cannot avoid. They're always there. But we have the wisdom and the intellect and the knowledge to rise above the tamas and the rajas and to exist in the sattvic.
Jai Radhe Radhe, Jai Radhe Radhe Govinda. Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe, Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe, Govinda Radhe Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Kaliya,
Govinda Radhe Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Govinda Radhe Radhe Gopal Radhe. Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe,
Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda.
Everybody clap hands like a young man up in the air like it.
Radhe Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Govinda Radhe Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe,
Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe,
Gopal Radhe,
Govinda Radhe.
Radhe Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Govinda Radhe Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe,
Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe,
Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe,
Radhe Radhe
Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Govinda Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Govinda Radhe Radhe Gopal Radhe,
Radhe Radhe.